Welcome back to Worldwide Exchange. Amazon reportedly weighing another multi-billion dollar investment in Anthropic. According to the FT, the move by Amazon will look to strengthen their strategic partnership beyond the $8 billion it's invested in the AI company. Anthropic has so far declined to comment. The FT says a potential fresh investment would help Amazon keep its position as one of Anthropic's largest shareholders ahead of a $3 billion investment from Alphabet. For a closer look at the AI landscape, let's bring in Jack Hidary, CEO of SandboxAQ. Jack, good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning, Frank. How are you?
All right. So, Jack, all morning long, we've been talking about Nvidia crossing that $4 trillion mark, just a tick below last time we checked, but still very close to $4 trillion. That march happened pretty fast from 3 to 4. What does that signal about AI and the AI trade here in the U.S.?
We're seeing a number of signals, Frank. First of all, TSMC just released earnings about 20 minutes ago, and they had about a 39% increase in their revenue, and so they beat all their numbers. Another indicator of the strength of this AI market. You're seeing demand from the big players and also from sovereigns and others for these kinds of chips. My prediction is that NVIDIA and Microsoft will cross the $5 trillion mark, Frank, in the next 12, 18 months. I see no impediment to that happening. If we're in the current geopolitical general framework, I think we can easily see $5 trillion for those two companies. With TSMC's rise now, they now just joined the $1 trillion club. They're just at that hovering point of $1 trillion market cap. And that means there's now 10 different companies in the world today worth $1 trillion or more. So it's really exciting, Frank, to see all this movement.
Jack, I don't know if we ever asked you this. Are you an NVIDIA customer? Do you buy their chips? And I was actually talking to Dan Ives from Wedbush yesterday. He says there's basically 10 to 1 demand. There's 10 customers that want a chip for every chip that's actually available.
We're very fortunate, Frank, in that we're a special NVIDIA partner. Just spent time with Jensen yesterday. And we use the DGX Cloud. DGX Cloud is the way to use NVIDIA chips that are the latest chips. As you know, right now, there's Hoppers out there, but there's also Blackwells, and now upcoming will be the Vera Rubin chip. And so the way to access the latest and greatest from NVIDIA is the DGX Cloud, and we're fortunate to be a partner. And in fact, Frank, we just announced with NVIDIA 10 days ago, the initial results of that partnership is the largest data set for the biopharma world, 5 million plus molecules that we characterize using our Sandbox AQ software on NVIDIA DGX hardware. That's a breakthrough, Frank, for the biopharma world, developing drugs for cancer, Alzheimer's, other major diseases.
Jack, you're burying the lead on us. You were with Jensen Huang yesterday. What were you guys doing? Were you popping champagne, wearing leather jackets? Don't even answer. I want to get to some more important stuff for investors. Yesterday, we had Chris Heisey from Bank of America Merrill Private Bank. Here's what he said about the AI trade. I want to get your response.
We're on the verge of one of the greatest CapEx booms we've ever had, at least in the last 5 or 6 decades. And everything infrastructure around that, robotics, automation, generative artificial intelligence, data center buildouts, all of that is starting to begin to accelerate.
All right, so I want to get your take. What he's talking about is what a lot of people call, and I believe Jensen Huang calls, physical AI. Let's get beyond NVIDIA right now. Who are the other winners of this CapEx cycle, if you agree with what he has to say?
Sure. Let's talk Mag 7. Let's talk the rest of the economy. Then let's talk power and the power needed for this AI revolution. So Mag 7 right now, Frank, represents 34% market cap wise of the S&P 500. Mag 7, 34% of the S&P 500. But Mag 7, Magnificent 7, only represent 11% of the GDP of the United States. And so what that means is that there's 89% of the GDP out there that are lagging behind, both in the market cap rise that the analyst was just talking about and in adoption of AI. What you see in the Magnificent Seven is that AI is core to their business. It's driving their core revenues. And so companies like Microsoft, Google, and others, NVIDIA, it's driving the core business. For the rest of the economy, if you're a pharma company, if you're others, large language models, helpful. You can reduce some costs in customer service. But the core business of making a new drug, the core business of being an energy company, the core business of making an automotive product, if you're GM or Ford, that is not really being impacted by large language models. Of course, quantitative AI, the next wave of AI, is the key to that. So what we're seeing is a divergence. My prediction, Frank, on this show here is that we're going to see the percentage of market cap that Mag 7 represents going from 34% to 40% before the rest of the economy catches up.
That's a pretty bold prediction, Jack. Before we let you go, we're almost out of time. I want to talk about your business. What do you have going on in the second half of the year, whether it's in the AI space or the quantum space?
Well, there's a number of different areas that we're focused on. First of all, SAIR, SAIR, this new data set that we released with Nvidia, is the first of a number of data sets that we'll be coming out with using our quantitative AI, our LQMs, large quantitative models that allow us to produce high quality data sets and models that hit the core of developing drugs, developing new materials, all kinds of applications, including, of course, AQ Nav as well, navigating a plane in the face of no GPS. So a wide variety of quantitative applications. And we're also looking in the cyber realm now. AI and cyber, Frank, look for that to be a key trend for the second half of the year. As more attacks happen and enterprises need to defend themselves, the hackers are using AI. We also need to use AI to...
So, Jack, I tell you what, why don't you come back in a little bit and we'll have a deeper conversation just about cyber, AI, and also quantum. Jack Hidary from SandboxAQ, is always a pleasure to see you. Thank you very much.